See this plane, it's America's Mach 3 super bomber that you never heard about. The North American XB-70 Valkyrie was the largest and fastest bomber ever built by the United States, but the massive 6-engine Mach 3 capable jet never entered production. Only one surviving prototype sits in a museum in Dayton, Ohio, even as the Boeing B-52 it was supposed to one day replace continues to soldier on. The Valkyrie was not America's first operational supersonic bomber. That historical distinction goes to the Convair B-58 Hustler, who had made his own maiden flight on November 11, 1956, and although he never saw combat, had achieved a brief moment of Hollywood fame by playing the fictional Vindicator bomber in the 1964 war suspense thriller film Nuclear Failsafe, starring Henry Fonda and Walther Matthau. As for the XB-70, as the Federation of American Scientists FAS info page notes about the star-crossing bomber, with research and development studies beginning in 1955, the XB-70 is a large long-range strategic bomber, planned to be a replacement for the B-52. As in the B-58 program, Force wants new technological advances. To this end, the Air Force assigned total weapons systems responsibility to the prime contractor. Competition between Boeing and North America for contracts occurred during the design phase. In 1958, the North American design was selected and a development contract awarded. The Air Force's requirement was for a Mach 3 long-range high-altitude bomber capable of carrying both nuclear and conventional weapons. The idea behind these 70 originated in the 1950s when it was assumed even greater speeds and altitudes would enable American bombers to survive against Soviet air defenses unmolested on their way to delivering their doomsday payloads. At the time, the only effective defense against bombers were fighters and anti-aircraft artillery.